Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Hafiz, a cardiologist based in London, and today I'm going to talk about something that is both fascinating and often misunderstood, Postural Tachycardia Syndrome, or POTS for short. If it's your first time here on my channel, I give tips on how to keep your heart healthy and also explain heart conditions in a way that is easy to understand. If that interests you, then click on the subscribe button and bell icon so you get notified every time I release a video. If you ever stood up quickly and felt dizzy or noticed your heart racing, you've had a small taste of what patients with POTS deal with every day. But in POTS, this isn't just an occasional event, it's a chronic condition that can have a major impact on someone's quality of life. So let's break it down step by step, starting with what POTS is. POTS is a disorder of the autonomic nervous system, the part of your body that controls things automatically, like blood pressure, heart rate, digestion, and sweating. In POTS, when a person stands upright, their body has difficulty adjusting to gravity. When you move upright, gravity makes some of your blood flow downwards in your body, which leads to a drop in blood pressure. Normally, your body responds by narrowing your blood vessels and slightly increasing your heart rate to increase blood pressure and keep blood flowing to your heart and brain. But if you have POTS, these automatic changes in your blood vessels do not happen. This means the supply of blood to your heart and brain changes when you sit or stand up, so your heart beats very fast to try to make up for this. This can leave people feeling dizzy, lightheaded, fatigued, anxious, and sometimes even faint. We do not fully understand yet why this part of the nervous system does not work the way it should in people with POTS. It's thought that in some cases, POTS may be triggered by a bacterial or viral infection such as COVID-19 or glandular fever, pregnancy, surgery, or a traumatic event. Now, diagnosing POTS requires a systematic approach. Let's talk through how that usually happens. The initial assessment always begins with a comprehensive evaluation. That means taking a detailed clinical history, reviewing baseline autonomic symptoms, and most importantly, excluding other possible causes. This is important because conditions like dehydration, anemia, thyroid problems, or even medication side effects can mimic POTS. A thorough review ensures we're not missing something treatable or reversible. Once the initial history and examination are done, one of the key bedside tools we use is the active standing test. This is a simple but powerful diagnostic test. First, we measure your blood pressure and heart rate at baseline, either when you are sitting down or lying down. Next, you stand upright and we repeat measurements at 1 minute and again at 3 minutes. In some people with POTS, we'll see that characteristic rise in heart rate, often accompanied by symptoms like dizziness, palpitations, or nausea. Documenting these changes is essential to making the diagnosis. You may also be referred for a tilt table test. This is a procedure where the position of your body is changed while you lay on a special bed. The tilt test is done in a quiet dark room to help you relax. Before the tilt test, electrodes are attached to your chest and connected to a machine that monitors your heartbeat. A blood pressure monitor will be attached to your arm, and you'll be asked to lie down flat for 5 minutes on a special bed that is able to tilt. You'll be strapped to the bed to stop you from falling. During the test, your bed will be slowly tilted upwards to around 60 to 90 degrees, so that you're nearly stood upright. This will continue for up to 20 minutes or until you feel dizzy or faint and show a change in your heart rate or blood pressure. If you feel unwell, the healthcare team will look after you. If you are still feeling well, you may be given a glycerol trinitrate or GTN spray under your tongue and tilted for another 15 minutes. This can help to recreate your symptoms by making your heart rate a little faster and your blood pressure a little lower. At the end of the test, you'll be allowed to sit up and given a glass of water before you're ready to go home again. The appointment can last between 1 to 2 hours, but you will only be in a tilted position for 15 to 45 minutes of that time. Even if your test is negative or does not show anything, the information collected can be useful for other tests and treatments. We also have to make sure there isn't an underlying structural or primary heart problem that could be responsible for your symptoms. That's where standard cardiology investigations come in. An echocardiogram is used to assess your heart's structure and pumping function. I've done a whole video explaining this test in detail, so check it out later. An ECG can reveal rhythm disturbances. A Holter monitor, worn for 24 hours or longer, can help us pick up episodes of fast or irregular heartbeats in daily life. In POTS, all of these investigations are usually normal, and that's part of the point. We're ruling out other conditions that can cause similar symptoms. So once we've made the diagnosis, the next big question is, how do we manage it? Management of POTS is usually multifaceted. It almost always starts with lifestyle measures. You are encouraged to increase your fluid intake, often aiming for 2 to 3 liters of water per day, and to increase salt intake unless there's a medical reason not to. The idea here is to expand blood volume, making it easier for the body to maintain blood pressure when standing. Compression stockings that cover the thighs and abdomen can also help reduce blood pooling in the legs. Exercise like cycling or swimming is often prescribed as a graded program to improve autonomic control and cardiovascular conditioning. But lifestyle measures alone aren't always enough. That's where first-line pharmacological treatments come in. Two of the most commonly tried medications are fludrocortisone and midodrine. Fludrocortisone works by helping the body retain more salt and water, thereby expanding blood volume. This can reduce the severity of the heart rate rise when standing. Midodrine, on the other hand, acts as a vasoconstrictor. It tightens up the blood vessels, preventing blood from pooling in the lower body and helping to maintain blood pressure. Your doctor may also consider medication to slow down your heart rate with a beta blocker such as propranolol or bisoprolol. Another medication that may be used to slow down your heart rate is evabradine. Of course, medication isn't a one-size-fits-all solution. Some patients respond very well, others less so, and side effects can limit their use. That's why it's important to monitor closely after introducing these treatments, adjusting as needed, and always combining them with the non-pharmacological strategies we mentioned earlier. What's important to emphasize is that POTS is a very real condition. Patients often face years of feeling dismissed or told that it's just anxiety. While anxiety can certainly be a symptom, because anyone would feel anxious if their heart's rate shot up every time they stood up, it's not the root cause. Understanding that POTS is an autonomic dysfunction is key, and with the right diagnosis and management plan, many patients can see significant improvement. To sum it up, POTS is characterized by an abnormal heart rate rise upon standing caused by dysregulation of the autonomic nervous system. The diagnostic pathway involves a careful initial assessment to rule out other causes, confirmation with an active standing test, and supportive cardiology investigations to ensure the heart itself is structurally and electrically normal. Management includes lifestyle measures like hydration, salt, compression, stockings, and exercise, alongside first-line medications like fludrocortisone and midodrine when appropriate. If you or someone you know is struggling with unexplained dizziness, palpitations, or fatigue when standing up, it's worth discussing POTS with your doctor. If you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up and share it with someone who might benefit. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.